In a televised appearance alongside his designated successor, the embattled two-time prime minister of Iraq, dropped his acrimonious bid to remain in power for a third term. He's stepping down after losing support from his own party and most of his allies at home and abroad. Mr. Maliki announced his decision at a meeting of his Dawa party Thursday evening.
I announce before you today, in order to facilitate the political process and the formation of a new government, the withdrawal of my candidacy in favor of the brother, Dr. Haider al-Abadi.
Many have blamed years of Mr. Maliki's sectarian policies for the violent Sunni-led insurgency in Iraq. He failed to reach an agreement with Washington to keep a contingent of U.S. troops in the country beyond 2011. And he has pushed the once powerful Sunni minority out of his ruling coalition, creating the resentment that the rebels now exploit. Mr. Abadi has the support of the United States, Europe, and neighboring Iran. But U.S. President Barack Obama has made it clear the future of Iraq depends on Iraqis.
We will continue airstrikes to protect our people and facilities in Iraq. We have increased the delivery of military assistance to Iraqi and Kurdish forces fighting ISIL on the front lines. And perhaps most importantly, we are urging Iraqis to come together to turn the tide against ISIL, above all by seizing the enormous opportunity of forming a new, inclusive government under the leadership of Prime Minister designate Abadi.
France and Britain have promised humanitarian aid for Iraqi minorities displaced by violence and arms for the Kurdish militias struggling to stop the militants.
Yes, of course, we do support the Kurds, and we should continue to support the Kurds. And as you know, in terms of the ammunition that they're getting, Britain is going to be playing a role in helping to get that to them.
But there are no plans to get involved in fighting in Iraq.
En ce qui concerne la participation,
regarding taking part in direct bombing, that's for the Americans to act on. We will only intervene if the United Nations Security Council gives us the authorization and if the conditions come together, which is not the case currently.
The new prime minister is facing a huge task of rebuilding national unity after its unraveling in recent months. He has expressed confidence that Iraqis will unite to fight off the extremists who have left death and destruction in their wake. Claritza Ho, VOA News, Washington.